Now, Ontario is one of several provinces loosening the vaccine guidelines this week. So far, just under 40% of Canadians have received their first dose. Yukon leads all provinces and territories with almost 63% of its residents getting at least one dose. BC and Ontario, somewhere in the middle. PEI has the lowest vaccine uptake at about 30% of its residents getting that first dose. For these Canadians, their second dose is months and months away. So in the meantime, how much protection does one dose give, and how do variants change the landscape? We have your answers to your questions with infectious diseases specialist Dr. Susie Hoda and Dr. Lenora Saxinger. So thank you both for joining us again. And Dr. Saxinger, I really wanted to start with you. With more Canadians getting this crucial first dose of the vaccine, lots of people are asking this question we got on video. Let's have a look.
What are my chances of still contracting COVID-19 after my first shot? And how protected am I from hospitalization if I do get infected?
So this is the question, again, about the first shot. Everybody knows that we need the second shot, but really, how safe are we after the first?
I can say that the first dose of any of the available vaccines actually offers a lot of protection, especially against severe disease, hospitalization, and death. Sometimes we might see the phenomenon where the first dose might convert COVID to a cold, so you might still get symptomatic infection. The range of efficacy numbers, which is the trial-based numbers, perfect world numbers, for the mRNA vaccines like Pfizer or Moderna is 95% plus. The real world numbers tend to come in around 80% or more protected, and that means you're protected, you're 80%, I guess, less likely to get infected than someone who is not immunized. For the AstraZeneca vaccine, which a lot of people have gotten over the last several weeks, that protection against hospitalization and death is really very, very good quite early after 2 or 3 weeks, as with the Pfizer and Moderna vaccines. But the protection against any infection symptoms at all is a little slower, and it actually continues to build over 3 months. So the nice thing about that is, you know, you're not losing any effectiveness of the vaccine over that first few months. And that particular vaccine, actually a later boost seems to work better. So there's a good interval there.
Okay, and Dr. Hoda, if I project a little bit, after a second dose, I mean, are people basically fundamentally safe after that second dose?
You know, our real life experience so far with these vaccines is very much tracking along those lines. And what we saw with the clinical trials, so with Moderna and Pfizer, you know, we're really seeing 90 plus percent effectiveness in real life in countries like the UK and Canada, Israel, the US, you know, many places where we've been rolling this out over the last several months. So, you know, your protection from infection is really quite good. And from those severe outcomes, excellent. So I think that's an important outcome, but nothing is 100% effective. So we have to recognize there will be some breakthrough infections that we hear about over time, and that is to be expected.
Okay, so along the line, we have another video question for you, Dr. Hoda, along the lines of what is coming. Because the variants make up the majority of new cases being reported across the country, lots of people have variants on the mind. Here's one for you.
I understand that the first dose of the vaccine will afford you some protection against getting seriously ill from COVID-19. My question is, does the first dose also afford you some protection against getting seriously ill from any of the variants?
Dr. Hoda?
It's an excellent question, and I think we have, you know, slightly more limited information when you start to divide it up into all the different types of variants of concern and interest that are circulating. What we know is a B117 variant, which is the one that arose out of the UK initially and is now actually a predominant variant in many parts of Canada, seems to respond really well to the vaccines. And it's very similar to the kinds of outcomes as we're seeing with earlier variants. So great protection. And everything we've said about protection after one dose, two doses applies probably with a B117, or at least very close. With the other variants of concern in Canada, we have less information. And we're getting some about the B1351 variant. This is the one that first arose in South Africa. And there was a study that was published out of Qatar that actually did show that there was some reduction in the effectiveness of two doses of vaccine, down to about 75% with this variant. And unfortunately, we can't really know exactly how well one dose protects against this variant just because of the way that data was reported.
Okay, excellent. Thank you. Dr. Saxinger, here's another question we got on video. This one's for you.
How effective is the first dose over time if I have to wait 4 months for the second dose.
So again, we talked about the AstraZeneca building over time with that delay, but when you're looking at the Pfizer and Moderna, what happens over the course of that 4 months?
There's actually less data overall for the intermediate time points for the Pfizer and Moderna vaccines. Like, we had good data out to 4 to 6 weeks from one dose, and that was just related to delays in the initial trials. Then there's been some effectiveness data from the UK that actually suggests that the Pfizer vaccine is very similar in effectiveness to the AstraZeneca vaccines in older people. And so my net is that we have every reason to suspect that most people will have good protection after one dose. Particularly, we have better data for the AstraZeneca vaccine. And for the Pfizer and Moderna vaccine, you actually get a very good antibody level that doesn't seem to decline very quickly. And so we expect similar for that. So for most people, that second dose delay allows your second dose to become someone else's first dose while we have a lot of disease spreading. And that actually helps protect the entire community.
And just to follow on that, Dr. Saxinger, where are we at with the understanding about whether those who had a first dose of AstraZeneca should be getting a second dose of Pfizer or Moderna?
There is a trial that's ongoing, and I think we expect it to be reported in a relevant time frame. There's also new trials starting elsewhere, but there's a UK trial that was switching between first dose Pfizer versus AstraZeneca and then second dose AstraZeneca versus Pfizer. So we'll get data from that over the coming months, really within the time period that we kind of need it. I think a lot of people suspect that with some other vaccine products, giving a different type of booster sometimes gives a very good response. And so I think people are optimistic that we'll be able to give second doses with the mRNA product.
And last brief word to you, Dr. Hoda, what can you say to people who just have had their first dose, who feel so elated but so nervous about what's next?
A few things, actually. So first of all, it takes your body a couple of weeks to build up an immune response. So, you know, it's really important that you be absolutely careful in terms of avoiding contact with other people, wearing your mask, just, you know, doing everything you need to do to prevent getting infected in that period of time. And in fact, until you get your second dose. And that's my next point. It's still really important to get your second dose. It's great that you have good protection after one dose, but it shouldn't mean that you defer your second dose. And the final thing I wanted to say is it's great to have gotten vaccinated and to get onto that track. I think there's hope on the horizon as we roll out more vaccine and also keep in place the public health measures that are really important to drive down the numbers so we can all see, hopefully a pleasant summer.
Oh, we need that so much. Dr. Hoda, Dr. Saxinger, thank you both so much.
Thank you.